him.
Really?
Hold tight, leave for the result. Hold tight, come on, under me. Let me tell him now. Yo. Anyway, I told you I read him in our play.
The funny thing about Powell, when everyone was in the studio and they heard the beat, hardly anyone liked the beat. Because I remember this was around the time where Wiley was making lots of kind of Eskimo sounding records. And if it didn't kind of have that sort of esky sound, people didn't really get it. So I remember DEE was like, bruv, what's this?
Sometimes you're slipping. It's like you hear a beat, you're not sure about it. And then you jump on the beat, and then the guy that was telling you, trust me, then it popped off, and then you're like, raw, that was me slipping, and now I'm actually feeling the beat after, and I'm feeling it, but this is the beat I turned down, like, what's going on?
When I got to the studio, there was a session that just finished with Dirty Dogs at the time. And I remember I was like, yo, like, I got this track. Like, pow. Yeah, I always jump on it. And these times, I think he just, like, he had his little battle with Wiley. So, like, he was kind of a guy at the time. And I remember I see him looking at me thinking, he goes to me, what's this, pal? What's it a nade of, though? What's this track a nade of? I said, but I'm just trying to ting, innit? Like, nothing ain't really going on in the game right now, so I'm just trying to link up with the man name and do something. And he was just like, yeah, ring me. When the time came, rang him. Phone just rang out still, but boy, it's all good.
This is my first experience in regards to the forward rhythm, yeah? And Lethal B can vouch for this, yeah? I saw Lethal B in the One Extra building, and it was like, yo, Viz. It was in what we called, like, at that time it was more CDs, you feel me? So it wasn't so much email your tune to a DJ and whatnot. So he was in the building, he was in the post room looking for DJs, pigeonholes, and he, that's what they called him back in the day still. And he was asking me, yo, what DJs do you reckon would play this forward with him still? So I showed him what DJs I felt like the tune was appropriate for, including myself. So Lethal B can vouch on that one still.
First time I heard Pal, you know what, I can't actually pinpoint it down to an exact day, week or month, but it would have been around about back end 2003, 2004, during the Channel U days, during the heydays of Channel U. And just remember sitting in my house and just seeing this video play over and over again. And it was, you know, it was Lethal B and it was the man them. And that was probably the first time I heard Power. Back in the 2003, beginning the 2004, if my memory serves me correctly.
My bridge in Wesley's house, like, I mean, he had the, I think, I'm going to say premiered, but obviously in them days it weren't premiered. It was on, someone played it on Deja. My brethren used to tape all the sets for me on mini disc, and he rang me like, yo fam, like, this tune's mad. Come round, we live like 5 doors away from each other. So I've gone over there, listening to it like, fam. You know, when I first heard that, it was like, it was almost like hearing something alien, you feel me? I listening to it over and over again and thinking, sick, you get me?
When the tune came back and I heard it, and me as a what was that? Must have been about 19 or something, 18, 19. I remember listening back and thinking, rah, there's 10 of the biggest MCs in the game on my tune. This is mad. So I was like, rah, like, I can't wait till everyone hears it. But you know what it is? Before then, I'd never seen a tune get that big.
So after the song was done, I was in the studio trying to get the order right, because the way we recorded it wasn't how I wanted the order to be. So I structured it. Then, at the time, we'd done it in a famous DJ called Commander B Studio. He used to be on Choice FM these times. And I wanted to plan when to drop it. Commander B just got a bit ahead of himself and just played the record on the radio. I remember waking up, just seeing bare missed calls, bare texts. Yo, what's this Power song? You need to send it to me. And I'm thinking, what? How does man know about this Power song already? Then I get a call from an ex man like, yeah, heard your new one on Commander B last night. And I'm thinking, oh, Commander B, man, why are you playing it without even telling, man? So I called him. I was like, fam, like, I wasn't ready to drop it yet. And he was like, you know what, Biz? The way the tune's popping, I swear down, I ain't had a tune pop my line off like this for time, bruv. He was gassing it to me, and I'm thinking, yeah, he's like, bruv, the tune's a monster, you know. So I thought, all right, cool. So he started playing it more, playing it more, playing it more. Then the record just started growing. DJs from all over the country started like getting my number. I'm like, yo, you need to send me this Power record. So I was just like, wow, like it just felt the scene was coming alive again. And the next step after that was the video.
I was at home watching Channel U, and then I saw these two Mixed Race Girls on TV and the old school Apple Mac computer. And then I just remember a wheel spinning and ow, I said, what the hell is this?